was it negotiating this series and the other family series with the Marvel Universe as a whole? Did they tell you what characters you can use? Are they kind of keeping the gates between the universes separate?
Well, you know, there are characters that are sort of sequestered in feature films to some extent. Although we have Captain Marvel featured prominently in several of these specials like this one, and I'm a big Carol Danvers fan. But actually, in this case, girls told us which characters they wanted. We gave them a large slate to pick from, and we wanted to have characters that represented different races, religions, and body types, but we weren't prescriptive in any way. Girls told us which characters they were emotionally connected to with the most, and that's what created our final list.
My daughter, I have two daughters, they're 8, they're perfect age for this show, they love it.
Oh, good.
One's favorite is Squirrel Girl, and the other loves Ghost Spider.
Oh, that's a tough choice, but I'm a little more of a Squirrel Girl fan. I have the Squirrel Boy ears, but I decided not to wear them today.
So if there's a lot of new Captain Marvel fans thanks to that movie, how happy are they going to be to see her in this special?
I hope that's another incentive to watch, because then they get to see a different side of character. Like, the film is Carol figuring herself out. Well, now she's an established hero, and she can be tough, but she can also be a great mentor. And watching her with the Super Warriors in the feature length and in this one is really interesting. You also get to see how tough she is when she's in battle with Hala the Accuser. And I think that's a really cool thing, too. So you get the very human side, and then you get like a big old Captain Marvel blowout battle. You can have both, and girls like both.
Mary has a really difficult backstory.
Yes.
How was it like walking the line from the lighter to the darker, and also moving where she's
That's a challenge we have with Ghost Spider as well. Girls are very interested in rising above hardship and pain. So we like to demonstrate that without getting too explicit in terms of the most difficult things that happen. It is a fine line that you walk because you want moms to feel comfortable that the kids are watching something that's not too dark and scary. So we often handle it in flashbacks lightly so that we can establish it. But the characters living in the present day and resolving these emotional issues. Good question.
Can I piggyback off of Hala? I know girls love heroes, and I'm really excited to see so many different, diverse girl heroes. There are also girls who love villains.
Mm-hmm.
We've seen Hala. Do you think there's a chance we might see some other female villains?
Yes.
Because there is a definite lack of them in the MCU.
Yes. We are going to announce. I won't say anything I'm not supposed to. PR. We are going to announce some more specials today. And we're not going to talk too much about the villains, but two of them have really tough, intense, and interesting female villains. And I do think that's important. And we're even going to create a pop song for one of them. Because we think that bad girl perspective is something that girls can sort of connect with. That may not be them, but they understand that instinct and they want to understand that character's evolution as well.
Awesome. I'm excited.
How do you... you're making shows that are aimed at kids, but also you want their parents to be watching with them. And I've found that this is a show that I can enjoy as much as the kids can. So how do you kind of calibrate that so it's something that everybody can enjoy together?
Well, I think a great character story is a great character story regardless. And I think moms and dads, and we actually had lots of conversations with moms and dads in the development of this project. And they want different things, which is very interesting. Dads want superheroes that the girls can connect with and relate to because they love superheroes. They get angry when there's not enough superhero stuff for their daughters. Moms want stories that are meaningful to the girls that will help them to be better people in the world, which is what our stories are always about. And the idea that friendship and teamwork are good values to have and relationships to build that make you stronger and better as a person. So, and then just the idea of everybody being the best version of themselves is appealing.
So with so many characters in Marvel Universe, how do you go about deciding who comes in? I mean, it must be, what is it? There's something like thousands of options. How do you decide?
I hear anywhere from 8 to 10,000.
Is it She-Hulk? Is it this one? Is it this one?
Well, like I said, in the establishment of this, we actually gave a dozen characters for girls to think about and look at. And they told us which ones they found most interesting, that they could connect with emotionally. We'd always planned to include Riri. But we knew that we had to introduce a couple of the characters, then establish the team, then bring Ghost Spider in and find a reason for her to become part of a team. And then we'd have room to tell Riri's story, which is an expanded story, 44 minutes, because her backstory is really interesting. And she has a huge arc, even within this special, in terms of being a real loner, just focused on her inventions, to being a friend and a teammate with somebody who uses her inventions to make the world a much better place.
It sounds like you're teasing an arc that sort of ties it all in together. Are you building towards something big?
We have more stories to tell, but the thing that we're building to that's big is not necessarily a big explosive battle to save the Earth, although there kind of is one here. But it's about these young people doubting themselves and figuring out and eventually becoming great heroes. Just using the skills and the smarts that they have to become the best version of themselves and make the world a better place.
I wish there'd been people like you when I was a kid. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Are you going to stay in the world of doing movies, these events, or are you going to go back to shorts? Is there a vision for the future in terms of story length?
We'll see.
PR says we'll see. We'll have an announcement at the panel today. I personally think that a really robust, defined story is the best way to go, and you'll see how we're going to tell some more of those in different formats.
Can they do 30 seconds?
Okay.
30 seconds. Okay. Quick games. Two games. First one is either or. We'll give two options. All you just pick one.
Okay.
Right? No thinking. Miss Marvel or Captain Marvel?
Oh, God. Miss Marvel.
Iron or Vibranium?
Vibranium.
Spider or Squirrel?
Squirrel.
Patriot or Captain?
I used to enter art contests at the age of 9 with pictures of Captain America, so I have to say Captain.
Animation or theme park?
Animation.
Okay, last part. Word association. Just first thing that pops in your mind, and then we're done.
Uh-huh.
Rising.
Heart.
Lockjaw.
Cattles.
Marvel. First thing.
First thing. Connections. I know that's weird, but...
Squirrel.
Boy.
Iron.
Heart.
Miss.
Hmm?
Miss.
Well, Marv.
Patriot.
Patriot. Shield.
Last one. Spoilers.
I can't give spoilers. Spoilers. She's standing there watching. The one thing that I will say is there are other female black geniuses in the Marvel Universe. There's a couple of them, so you're going to have to decide later what that means. There'll be an announcement.